We're just taught to like survive as artists. You know, like we're taught to take initiative. Hi everyone, my name is Melody. I use she, her pronouns. I'm an interdisciplinary student here at Interlochen. I'm a first year junior. I do singing, songwriting, dance, theater, what else do I do? creative writing, and I sort of kind of compose a little bit. And I'm from Almaty, Kazakhstan.
Hi, I'm Manira. I use she, her pronouns, and I'm an interdisciplinary student with an emphasis on film, writing, and drawing. What? I'm from Grand Rapids, Michigan.
And what grade are you?
11th.
My name's Nadine. I am a senior here at Interlochen, and my focus is visual arts, animation, and I like to volunteer in the theater department with costume and crew tech. It's honest work.
I can start.
Yeah, go for it.
I would say that the interdisciplinary program is basically anything that you make it for yourself, because the only requirement that you have is that you are required to take 2 arts electives every semester, but you have a lot of freedom in terms of like which projects you take on, you know, what you do, what classes you take, what areas you study. I think it's pretty cool if you're very self-motivated.
I agree. Like, I always love about the major that, like, no one's, like, holding your hand and telling you what to do, what classes to take. But I know so many people who are truly so ambitious in our major, and it's so diverse for that reason.
I always say that we're any major that you want without any other responsibilities. It's really fun. I mean, you're able to take whatever classes you want. And the directors, like, Stephen and Clyde, they both are really hands-on. They're very cool. They're both really hands-on with the students and figuring out what path they need to take for what they want to do later.
Another thing that I really enjoy about the division is like how closely you can work with your instructors, because I literally barge into Clyde's office like every day at 1 and we just have a conversation about like anything. Who wants to start?
I can go.
Okay.
I think it's very free form, and because of that, a lot of the art we make comes from a place of genuine passion rather than like required or like requirements. And in general, I think that's because of the department I'm in.
I don't know. I wouldn't describe my experience in this department as anything but like really, really great. It's also really cool because you have very easy access to people with like a range of skill sets, because everyone in Interdis is so different that you can't really compare anyone to anyone, because everyone's just like, the work that we're doing, it's unique.
I know some people are saying like, oh, I have mistress style, some people haven't, and I find I could be in that same bubble where I can go at my own pace because of, again, how loose the schedule can be. That's the best way I can kind of add on to it.
I feel like people kind of assume that if you're interdisciplinary, it's because you're not good at what you do. We're just taught to like survive as artists. You know, like we're taught to take initiative. We craft our own path, pretty much, I think. Because one of my instructors always says that like when they don't give you opportunities, you make your own opportunities. And I feel like that's pretty much the rule that we follow.
Mm-hmm. I really like critiques. I mean,
you do?
I like them. I like them. I don't know about you, Miss Complainer. I like it. It's fun. We every week on Wednesdays we go to critiques. We split between 2 groups, and you get more space to talk about your stuff, and you can show people your stuff, and get criticism and collaboration and all this fun stuff, which is I enjoy it.
My favorite thing about the major is, I mentioned earlier how like you are really challenged in like classes, because you can't really get in certain classes, but you're challenged again as an artist, which you were going on about, you're talking about, sorry, poor wording. And I think what you said was very realistic with how you're challenged to like break into the artist world.
Whatever is going on in your work, you always have like people behind your back who are always chill and always like calm, and they're always going to say something to make you feel better or guide you in the right direction. Mm-hmm. So, like, you're challenged, but you're not, like, falling short with no support.
I feel like I have a good answer to that.
Because when I just started studying, I was like, well, I'm a singer-songwriter, and I do some other things on the side. Nuh-uh. Like, now I'll just say I'm an interdisciplinary artist, because what I did not know before I started studying is that there are not just, like, separate disciplines that you study. I was put in a composition class, because I don't remember why I requested it. I'm not sure what I was thinking, but I remember being, like, really freaked out, because it was just, like, I don't really know that much music theory, and, like, everyone else in this class pretty much is a music major, and they're so much better than me. And you know what? They are. Like, I go come into that classroom, and I'm just like, wow, I'm truly the worst. But
I feel like critiques.
No, but that is, like, such a great way to grow, because when you're in a room where everyone is better at what they do than you are, it's just, like, I don't know, it pushes you in a very unique way.
Being given equipment, I think, is my favorite part. I liked drawing, sort of, when I came here, but I was like, eh, I'm not that good at it. And then Clyde gave me a tablet, and I love it, and I draw on it all the time, and, like, the art improvement is ridiculous. It's so much fun.
My focus before coming here was just painting, but then I branched out and started building up all, like, my other skills. It's so important to have strong soft skills in multiple departments, so collaboration or looking for opportunities outside of school. People doubt that so much here, and I think interdisciplinary really builds up on that.
Yeah. They don't really question the things that you need, because I just told my division director, hey, I'm doing this project and I need a rope. Can you get me a rope? He got me a rope.
I went to my, I sent a list of things that I needed to one of my, to Tony, our district assistant, and the list was, and I quote, a baby doll, a baby blanket, a hospital gown, and a gun.
A prop gun.
She got it to me the next day, no questions.
It was a prop gun.
When you come to the interdis department, I know that it's not a very large school, but there are very large departments. So when you're applying for something like theater or creative writing or like visual arts, you definitely won't get as hands-on treatment as much as we have with our directors. Like, you know, with our director, like, they all know our names, they know our disciplines, what we're doing, they are, like, keep track of our projects. But for other departments, you know, there are some people who haven't even met the department director. So, and if you, you know, if you, like, value teacher-student relationships, it's definitely a department for you.
Yep, I agree.
I wish I knew that art is hard and that's okay. I know, because I kind of had an expectation that, like, you know, I'm going to go to an art school and I'm finally going to be able to, like, do all of those things that I love doing, and, you know, it's going to be wonderful, which it was, but I just didn't anticipate how hard it was going to be. And it was just a tad discouraging in the beginning, because, you know, I didn't anticipate it, and I thought, like, I'm struggling, this is hard, I don't always know what I'm doing, am I fit for this? So I just wish I knew that. So, like, there's nothing wrong with, like,
also,
struggling.
Not district specific, but more like for the school in general. I know my first semester when I came here, there was, like, a lot of a sort of competition culture around campus. Like, you know, like, all the different stuff everyone's applying to, like Young Arts and Scholastic and all these places. And then when you don't win or something, you also, like, you feel, you know, like, you don't kind of like you don't belong to be, like, you don't deserve to be here. There are so many artists around the world, and even if they're not globally known, it doesn't make the fact that they're great any less of a fact. You know, it's like, your art isn't going to be everyone's cup of tea, and that's okay.
I enjoy going through the struggle as an artist and trying to find myself, find my voice. Even through, like, the personal experiences I went on campus, I think it was just so influential to what I'm creating now, and I am so grateful for what I learned.
I mean, I remember, like, the very first thing that we have to do as interdisciplinary students is, like, introduce ourselves to the division, provide some examples of the work that we do. I played a song, I showed a dance that I did last year, and just to, like, give everyone a basic overview of, like, what kind of work do you do. And also feel like the division doesn't mold the program to, like, fit your needs. That's kind of your job. Mm-hmm. Because also as an interdis student, your needs kind of, like, evolve.
No, when you're coming into this major, you definitely need to have a sort of lens on what you know, but also what you want to learn. Because if Nadine said, like, if they came in and said, I want to do just painting the whole time, the whole way forward, then it wouldn't have, like, you know, the art that you've made now probably wouldn't have been made.
I was gonna say the program the major does not mold to you, the director you work with, Clyde or Steven, they're gonna work with you individually as a person and get you supplies, get you like maybe a workspace, help you get your schedule together. It's really all about building you up as an individual to work on the campus, and then you'll kind of come back to earth for critiques on Wednesdays and talk about your work, and that's where the program's like together. But again, when I say it's independent, like we mean it's so independent, and you can really work with how you want to work.
Self-driven and the one who wants to do too many things.
Honestly, anyone. Our department is so diverse. Yeah. No one's similar. Everyone's so different. I think anyone can join the department. Even if like you do have like one like major focus, but you're curious in other things, or just want to like schedule your work differently than like a traditional department here, interdisciplinary works really great for those working at their own pace.
You have to be self-motivated to sort of make the art that you really want to make. And having a clear idea of what you want to do is, I think, a requirement.
I would say don't expect things to be handed to you, and advocate for yourself and your department. Represent, don't complain, work hard, and diva.
I feel like it's not the department for you if you're not willing, if you're not like able or mature enough to do the work yourself to get your projects across. It's very independent. So when you like, when you come here, no one's really gonna hold your hand through it. And that's like a strength for a lot of us. And some, for like most people in our department, I feel having someone regulate what you can and can't do or say when it comes to your art is sort of like the reason why we belong in Interdis and not in the other majors.
I agree with Manira. I feel like you should, I think you will only be successful in Interdis if you have that internal drive and if you know what you want to do and you genuinely want to do it.
The social life and stuff doesn't matter. The art that you make here definitely does though, I feel.
Yeah. Also, yeah, process is the part that matters the most.
Oh yeah, mm-hmm. That's all they want to hear about at critiques. How'd you do that?
What was your motivation?
It's great.
Yeah, it is great. I like it.
Yeah, it's fun.
Thank you all so much.
Thank you. This was so fun.